Okay, welcome to the shell tutorial. As you may have noticed, I did not do this in the lecture or in the tutorial, and because I figured I will probably not have time for this, and I still think it may be relevant for some, I just thought I'd made a video about it. Okay, so this is all about the shell. Oh yeah, first of all, as you've seen here, I've activated some screen key thingy such that you see the keys I'm pressing here in the lower left corner of my screen. Okay, so what is the shell here? This is the shell. So the shell, other words for it are bash, cmd or command line, console, terminal, and so on. So a shell is generally an application program that runs programs on behalf of the user. So for example here, this here in Debian is called console, in Linux is generally referred to as terminal, in Linux and Mac, in Windows it's rather the command line or PowerShell. It's mostly this black box. In Windows you would press Windows and R, and then there would pop up a little dialog at the lower left corner where you press CMD for command line something, which will open the Windows terminal. Note, however, that the Windows terminal is not as powerful as the one for Unix-based systems. Okay, so basically what the terminal does, it runs programs on behalf of the user. So for example, I can type Firefox in here and it will start the program Firefox for me. Okay, so everything under the hood in an operating system basically runs over such a shell. Actually, your desktop, where you have the icons you can click, is basically also a shell. A shell refers to the outer layer of your operating system. Okay, so shell, outer layer of the operating system, there are UI shells like your desktop environment, and those shells here on a terminal, on a command prompt. And yeah, then the terminal or command line, command prompt definitely refers to this thingy here. And then there's also the term bash. Bash refers to this very terminal here. Here you see bash with this and this syntax, because bash is even a full-fledged programming language. So there are, you can have if constructs and so on, such that you can, for example, start programs only under certain conditions or whatsoever. Okay, and generally, what I do, I go around my file system here and look for programs I can execute. So, for example, I can here press ls in my home folder. So, in Unix-based systems, the tilde character is the home folder. So, I'm now on my username at, so this is the user I'm logged in with. I could su to switch to the super user. Su generally stands for switch user. I will not log into the su because I'm showing my password here, which will switch user to the super user. I can also su to another user. Then there wouldn't be chris at my operating system, but something else. So it shows the user. I think this is the name of the computer, and then the path. So note that the tilde character is shortcut for my home directory in Unix-based systems. To print my working directory, I can use the command pwd print working directory, which will tell me that slash home slash chris is my home directory. Okay, I use the command cd to change directory. Wait, let me just delete that calc here because we're gonna recreate the name. So rm, for example, means remove. So if I now list the console of my directory again, you see that the calc, which was formerly here, is now removed. Rm remove. So, and I can just, for example, if I want to change to another folder, I can just change directory to, and then there's something which is really useful. I can just type the first letters, and as soon as it's unambiguous, I can press tab and it will autocomplete. In case, so further, note that dot dot stands for super folder. So if I change directory dot dot, I change to the super folder. Okay, note that if I press CD here and then start with a capital D and then press tab twice, will list me all the ones that correspond that correspond to what I typed so far. So I can, for example, could change to documents or donuts here. Further, if I press cd, so I can just cd to tilde to my home directory. I can even just press cd without, I can just type cd without any parameters to just change to my home directory too. Cd hyphen goes back to the last directory I was in. Okay, I could also cd to dot dot slash, I don't know, some dot dot slash NLTK data, whatever. You can change directory here, and now I'm in this folder, as you can see here. Okay. And like I said, most importantly, from the terminal you start other programs. Okay, so I can, for example, here start Python. So there is somewhere an executable, on Windows you'd call it executable, on Unix-based systems you'd call it binary. There's somewhere a binary called Python, and if I type Python, it will start Python. So this here is the Python interpreter. I can do whatever I want. I can print hello, and it will print hello. And so if I want to exit Python, I'm going to exit. Okay, so just as I do this, I can, for example, also use parameters. So Python, the executable Python, has you can pass arguments there. For example, I can Python minus C, which will interpret a string as Python code and then return and then print whatever I ask it to print here, because I asked it to print. Okay. So that's how you would run, for example, a Python, like a single Python line from your terminal. Okay. Further, on the terminal, there's the infamous editor VI. So VI, for non-terminal affine guys, is kind of hard to use. So I'm not sure if you want to use it. But there's also another video, I made another video on how you can run, for example, Atom from your console, even on Windows. So let's start by running Atom, the binary Atom, without any arguments, which will simply run the binary. I can, however, also as argument give the name of a file, let's call it calc, which will already open the file named calc in my home directory. So let's just type twd in there, which is, as we know, the command to print the working directory. Note that on Windows you would have to use atom.cmd on the command line, and then you can name of any of a file. So if I now ls here, we see that I created calc. And I can, for example, look at the content of calc by using the command cut, which will show me the content of it. I can also open it in the VI editor. However, if you're not used to it, the only command you will need to know is colon Q exclamation mark for quit without saving, which is probably really useful for you. or if you're, for example, using VI for git messages, colon WQ writes and then closes. Okay, so now I created this here. Now, can I run calc? No, I can't. Why can I not? Because calc is not executable yet. To make it executable, I need to change the modificators of that file with the command change mod and make it executable. Change mod plus x, oh yeah, I forgot the name of the file. Change mod plus x calc will make calc executable, which my fancy shell even tells me by printing it in green. So now I can run it. Dot slash means look in the current folder. Dot means the current folder. So dot slash means look in the current folder, and then for the program called calc, and then execute it. Now calc reprint my working directory, as the command in there says. Okay, to make explicit that this is a program written in Bash, as I said, Bash is a program language, I can start with the hash symbol exclamation mark and then the path of the interpreter, which is Bash in my case. So this line reads, this file is to be executed with the following interpreted by the following interpreter, and this it's the one that is in bin/bash. So there's a file in bin bash, which obviously is a binary file, so we can't look at it, that can interpret my calc. So if I now calc, it won't do anything else because the standard interpreter of the bash program is the bash language. Okay, so I can also write Python executables in there. For that, let's change calc here with Atom, and already had it open, so I need to reopen it because it didn't add the new line. Let's change the interpreter here to Python. So we're not sure where Python is, so let's assume Python, the binary of the Python interpreter, is in bin Python. That's a reasonable assumption. So let's run it again. Well, first of all, let's not use a command that doesn't exist in Python, but well, what about printing 1+1? So for now, one calc, it will tell me, oh, there is no /bin/python. However, I could type Python here, which opened my Python interpreter. To check which Python it takes if I run the command Python, I can use the command which Python, which will tell me where my Python is. It's in user/bin/python. So I need to change this here to user/bin/python. Okay, and if I now run ./calc, it will print the result of that.